This session is going to be an introduction to Pilates mat work. Very simple exercises, but an important base from which to build. Start off by thinking about your correct position. You want your feet hip width apart, with the feet and the knees in line with your hips. Your pelvis is in neutral, so rock it backwards and forwards a bit and find the point at which the pelvic bones are all on the same plane. Make sure that the weight at the top of the spine is across where, if you're a lady, the bra line, and if you're a man, you might guess where that is. And then your head is either flat on the mat, or, if you prefer, or to keep your neck in line, a flat, firm cushion. We're going to start with ribcage closure. Now, you lift your arms as you breathe in. As you breathe out, take them behind you, towards but not to the floor, and as you do it, make sure that your ribs don't come up. Breathe in as you lift, breathe out to take them down. And again, you're breathing in and a really strong breathe out to sink your ribs. And up. And take them down. One more time. Take them up. Blow out, bring them in, and take them down. Now take your arms up above your shoulders, have your hands facing each other. Breathe in as you reach up towards the ceiling. Breathe out as you let your shoulders drop down to the mat. Don't bend your elbows. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. And float your arms down. Good. Now we're going to just open one knee to the side, but we're going to keep the hip bones absolutely still. If you like, you can put your hands on your hip bones to ensure that that's what they're doing. Breathe in, breathe out, and just open one leg to the side. Breathe in and breathe out to bring it back. And then the other side. Now don't let the leg that's supposed to be still do anything at all, and certainly not open to keep the other one company. So you're opening and closing, and your pelvis is completely still. Good. And relax. Now we're going to stretch the right leg, and as we stretch the right leg, we're going to take the left arm behind. So breathing in to prepare, breathe out, stretching one the right leg, taking the left arm over. Breathe in to bring it back. And again, the other side. Keep the spine absolutely still, so you don't want those ribs to move again. Good. And rest. Now, taking a breath in to prepare, breathe out, pull your tummy in, and just float one leg up into what we call a knee fold. Breathe in to take it down. Breathe out and bring the other one. You do it smoothly, you breathe, and you're very careful not to let this leg come too close to your body. If you do that, your tummy switches off, which isn't what we want. We want a nice angle there. Now, if you find that really easy, you can try taking a second leg up. Never take both legs up at the same time, and definitely not both legs down at the same time. So if that was easy, and only if it was easy, you float one leg up on the same out-breath, you bring the other one to join it. You take the first leg down and the second leg down. And then you start with the other leg. Good. Now I'm only doing a couple of repetitions of these exercises. If you're doing this for yourself afterwards, you would do about 6 of each exercise. Now place your hands behind your head. Breathe in, breathe out, pull your tummy in, and lift the top of your spine. Breathe in and breathe out, go down. This is slow and gentle and very controlled. The arms stay out at the side, but you should be able to see your elbows in your peripheral vision. So breathing in, breathe out, extend the neck, lift, don't let the pelvis come and meet you, and come down. And again. And one more. And as I said, you can do as many as you like, but at least 6 would be a good workout. Now get rid of your head cushions. Try and get your feet a bit closer to your bottom. Mine are not very close because I have funny knees. Take a breath in to prepare and just tilt your pelvis into the mat. And breathe out as you bring it back. Breathe in, breathe out and tilt. And bring it back. And then try one more. And if you can, just begin to peel the spine off the mat until you come up into a bridge. Breathe in and breathe out and try and put your spine down one vertebra after another, just like a pearl necklace coming down into its velvet box. Good. And relax. So remember, try and breathe all the time, breathe correctly if you can, and also do as many repetitions as you feel you want to do.